Hello everyone, this is Harsha Sipani here. I'm a commercial photographer based in Raleigh, North Carolina. Today we're going to talk about food photography backdrops. I get asked quite a lot of questions where I get all my backdrops from, or if I paint them or if I buy them, where is it? Like, let's go ahead and answer all your questions. In 2020, I started taking pictures of the food that I created or made, and I wanted to take pictures, and I kept looking at few Instagram, Pinterest posts, and I saw those beautiful backdrops, and I wanted to use something similar because all I had was a white flat tabletop or a brown plywood tabletop. So I wanted to experiment a little more and see how I could create those textures and different colors to bring my food like pop out. So basically I started buying like these chart papers that you find at any dollar store or any craft store. So I started painting them with acrylic colors, and here they are. These are some of my hand-painted backdrops that I used on chart paper, and I used acrylic colors to bring those colors out. And there are quite a few that I used very, very commonly, mostly the subtle colors and the dark and moody backdrops. So I used different colors, different swatches, different patterns to bring these textures out. This one was one of my favorite. I used quite a lot for dark and moody pictures. And eventually my business started growing and I wanted to have something better, because with food, it gets spilled, with drink, it's always so messy, and chart papers are not very reliable and they cannot be grit for a very long time. So of course they are fine, I still have them, but it also makes sense if you have a proper backdrop. So here I'm going to teach you what to do and how to go buy it. So basically you will go to a hardware store, you will get the plywood and you will cut them in the size that you want. Usually they will do it at the hardware store for you, they'll cut them off the size that you want. So I got like two plywood the size of my table, and I think it's perfect. And the first time I cut it, like, it was really slim. The second time I got the plywood cut into like a little wider, that way I have more surface to work on. So it's up to you what size you want and how you want to cut them off. And then I got them home. I also got joint compound, few spray bottles to bring that color. So basically you can play with what color you want. And if you're looking for dark and moody, then you would go for dark shades like coffee, browns, gold and stuff like that. And if you want something light, then you will go for whites and grays or maybe peach, you know, lighter shades. So basically what I did was I got all of that, I brought it home. So the first thing we did is dusted off the plywood so there's no dust on it, and then I took some amount of joint compound. Obviously I didn't have the spatula or whatever it's called, so I took a yogurt container lid that I had, I cut it into two halves, and then that was my spatula. So you take good amount of joint compound in that spatula and then spread it in different directions to create those beautiful textures. Now you could do different things to create those textures. One is just dab it and then drag it. The other option is, once you have applied the joint compound, let it sit for like 15-20 seconds, and once it's like slightly dry, start dragging, so you will get this beautiful effect, water ripple kind of effect. And then the third one is, we used a handy broom that we had, and we started dragging it all over our plywood to create that bristle kind of effect. And the fourth one would be just creating different patterns and textures by taking good amount of joint compound on the edges and then dragging them off. So it completely depends on how you want to create those textures, but make sure that it's not quite too bumpy, because I have done that and my glasses are sometimes standing slightly awkward. So make sure that it's not too bumpy, like flatten them off if required. Now this has to sit at least for 8 hours. What I did is, I and my assistant Sanvi, we did this together, and we did it in the morning, and then we let it sit for the next day because we were busy doing other stuff. So get back next day and start painting, and here is the fun part. Now for this particular project, my friend Angela, she wanted to help me out. She wanted to see what I do and how I create these beautiful backdrops. So we took both our plywoods that were completely dried with the joint compound out in our backyard. And I was very particular that I wanted one that is like moody, dark whites, and the other one I wanted white. Maybe like a cementy concrete or something like bright, so that I can keep white subject or object on it too. So when we started out, we painted our first color, and this is nothing but it's called peek through color, so it doesn't have to be even, just spray it everywhere on the backdrop. So the first one we sprayed a magenta pink color as our peek through color, and for the second one we just painted it all white because I wanted it to be a white backdrop. So basically you don't have to be very particular about covering all the spots. It could be any like random surface, it could be anywhere, but make sure that you have that completely spread out in the entire backdrop. And this is not going to be the prominent color, this is not going to be the main color. Now comes the second part. The second color is actual color that you're going to use. So for the magenta pink color, I decided to use a peachy pinkish spray paint that I had, and I spread it, like I sprayed it all over the backdrop, and if I saw that there were spots, I started smudging it off and I started spreading that color evenly all over the place. And for the white backdrop, we decided to go with a chalk color. I had a grayish tint chalk color, and we start dabbing it all over our plywood on top of the white paint, and we start spreading it evenly to create that different color on the white painted backdrop. Now this was the second step. We let it dry for a few minutes. I know there's a lot of drying here, as Joni says, but let it sit for some time. And then now comes the actual third part, where you can create more definition or more depth in the backdrop itself. So for the magenta pink color, we sprayed good amount of water, so it created those droplets on the backdrop. And then I had a gold color that I usually use it to create golden egg. So I sprayed that evenly all over the backdrop. Now let this sit for some time. And meanwhile, what we did with the white backdrop is we sprayed generous amount of white paint again on that white backdrop to make sure that the gray was not like very prominent. We just wanted the white to be more prominent color. So we sprayed, we used sponge, we dipped it in water, and we started spreading it all over our white backdrop. More or less our white backdrop was ready, but we sprayed a little bit of peach pink color to create that different color, but I totally would not suggest going for that. And the last thing that we did for the magenta color is take off all the water that we have. Now those water droplets created an effect. When you spray those golds on that, the water doesn't have, it really didn't do anything at the spot where the water was. So everywhere else you have those gold colors sprayed all over. So it created a beautiful dimension or texture on that particular board itself. Now you can see how these two look. I'm really happy with the finishing. My friend on the other hand was not really happy, but I had to show her how we took the picture with an actual subject in it. And this is how it looks. I'm really happy. But don't forget to finish off the entire plywood with matte finisher so that your colors are completely locked in. Try to give at least 2 layers of that spray, giving at least 5 to 10 minutes of gap in between each other. That way you can lock the colors and they are good to go. And I've been using several other plywoods that I painted a while ago, and here all of these are, and I love, love, love them. And I use them quite a lot for food and drink photography specifically, because you really like to have those textures and beautiful colors in your pictures. And I hope you like this, and I hope this encourages you or inspires you to create your own backdrop. And if you do, please do not forget to share it with me. I would love to see them. Once again, thank you for coming. You will see another video coming soon. All the best. Take care. Bye-bye.